For the human body, outer space is a very dangerous place, subjecting the body to enormous variations in temperature, extreme radiation, a vacuum environment, and the impact of micrometeoroids and orbital debris. In the beginning, it wasn't much of a problem for astronauts. They simply wore a modified version of a jet aircraft pressure suit, and it was only pressurized if the cabin pressure failed. The astronauts stayed inside the flight capsule the whole time, so having a suit to protect against the dangers of outer space was not essential. During the Gemini missions and the first spacewalks, suits were more protective as astronauts were subjected to the extremes of outer space. But even so, these suits were not as complicated as today's suits. For one thing, they did not contain life support systems. A hose connected the astronaut to the spacecraft, provided oxygen to breathe, and air cooling for the suit. For the Apollo missions to the moon, the spacesuit had to protect astronauts while they were not only outside of the spacecraft, but also walking around on the moon. The old laced-up boots had to go, making way for boots for walking on rocky ground. The Apollo suits also had to have a self-contained life support system. Each spacesuit was custom-made for each astronaut. After the spacecraft fire that killed three Apollo astronauts in 1967, NASA required that the suits had to withstand temperatures of over 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit. The next phase of suits came with the space shuttle. During launch and return to Earth, astronauts wore the familiar orange suits, which could only be worn inside the spacecraft. For outside projects, they wore heavy white spacesuits with self-contained life support. No longer custom-made like previous suits, the shuttle suit was comprised of separate components, which could be assembled to make spacesuits to fit almost anyone, male or female. Several sizes of each component were made and placed on a shelf for use as needed. Getting into the current spacesuits is not an easy thing to do. First, the astronaut wriggles into the lower torso assembly and then rises into the top section, which is hanging on the wall of the airlock. The Snoopy cap provides all of the communication components. The gloves are added, and the last is the helmet assembly. The same heavy white suits used during the shuttle missions are currently worn for work outside the International Space Station. These spacesuits were not designed to be easily maintained by the crew, so are typically returned to Earth for servicing. Spacesuits need to have a pressurized atmosphere, sufficient oxygen supply, eliminate carbon dioxide, maintain a proper temperature, protect from micrometeoroids, protect from radiation, enable clear vision, allow easy movement of the body inside the spacesuit, enable easy conversation with others, such as ground controllers, other astronauts, and so forth, and facilitate movement around the outside of the spacecraft. Since NASA is planning to send humans to places far further than humans have ever gone before, including landing on an asteroid and landing on Mars, that means that new, more protective, flexible, and easier to get into suits are being developed. The new suits will make it easier to walk around, walk safely on rocky ground, and give protection from dust, which can be as rough as sandpaper. Mars has a carbon dioxide atmosphere, so the current life supports technology won't work. NASA is therefore working on an advanced life support system that will protect astronauts on Mars or in deep space by improving humidity control, oxygen regulation, and by continually removing carbon dioxide from breathing air, ending the need for canisters of carbon dioxide-absorbing lithium hydroxide. The life support system is being designed so it will last a long time and can be repaired by crew members in space or on Mars. The new suits are meant for use both in space and on planet surfaces. One new generation of spacesuit is called the Z-suit. NASA's Z-1 suit was the first generation of these new suits. The Z-suit has a rear entry hatch. Instead of being worn like clothing, the astronaut enters the Z-suit through its back port. This idea has moved out of the concept stage and is currently being tested. The new Z suit has a hard composite upper torso, which provides a long-term durability that will be required for future extravehicular activity. Even the gloves have undergone redesign. There are now 62 different sizes, with fine adjustments of finger lengths in each of those sizes. The Z2 suit also uses design elements like electroluminescent wiring, making it easier to see and identify the astronaut in total darkness. It uses Luminex wire and light-emitting patches. Even 3D printing is being used to produce some of the components of the Z suit. This is a transparent prototype of the Z1 suit, produced by Solid Concepts, Inc., using 3D printing. The Z2 suit is still in the prototype phase, so it won't actually be used until after further testing. After the Z2 is thoroughly tested, the results will be incorporated into the design of a Z3 suit, slated for final delivery in 2018 or 2019. This suit, called BioSuit, is being developed by MIT professor Dr. Davin Newman and offers a totally different concept. The astronaut is first scanned by a laser scanner to generate a mannequin. The BioSuit is then built on the mannequin for a custom fit. The suit is skin tight and applies pressure on the body to prevent tissue from expanding and blood from congealing. The suit is laced with a network of filaments that allow for normal movement but maintain the structure of the suit. Coils of wire actively compress the material. The filaments are like this heat-activated worm made of the same material. Since the suit does not use gas for pressure like traditional suits, it can be easily repaired in case of damage to the suit. New heads-up helmet displays are being developed, which will eliminate charts and information attached to astronauts' wrists. They will provide real-time information about the astronaut's environment and orientation, projected onto the inside of the helmet while exploring alien worlds. Developed by Aurora Wearables, this internet-connected spacesuit is currently being used on the ISS. It features a vision board on the suit sleeve, a wearable hug, using inflatable material that squeezes the wearer's shoulders when a family member back home is thinking of them, and a 3D printer in the pocket that delivers tools and parts direct to the suit. It has been sewn using conductive thread that carries power and data to the embedded devices. Other spacesuits and concepts are being developed and tested, including these used with inflatable spacecraft modules. With an eye on exploring deep space, NASA is focused on developing new technologies that one day will be used in a suit worn by the first humans to step foot on an asteroid or on the Red Planet.